Good morning, friends. I am Dr. D. N. Pansare, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Devgiri College, Aurangabad. Today we have take the organic chemistry paper. Okay, in this organic chemistry paper, there are 7 chapters. Today we have seen the step by step. Okay, in this paper, the 7 chapter is there. First chapter is structure and bonding mechanism of organic reactions, stereochemistry, alkane, alkene, arene, and aromaticity, and alkyl and aryl halides. So today we have seen the chapter number first is structure and bonding. So let us see what is the basic concept in this chapter. First we will see the origin of the chemistry. Organic chemistry is study of carbon compounds. Why is it so special? 90% of more than 30 million chemical compounds contain carbon. Okay, we know that many or every one compound containing the percentage of the carbon is more than 1900. Exaggeration of carbon is periodic chart answer some of these questions. Carbon is a group 4a element. It can share 4 valence electrons and from 4 bond. Describing chemical bond, there are 2 methods. First is valence bond theory. What is valence bond theory? We can see the what is meant by valence bond theory. Covalent bond form 2 atoms approach each other closely so that a singly occupied orbital, 1 atom overlap a singly occupied orbital on the other atom. 2 models to describe covalent bonding. One is valence bond theory and second is molecular orbital theory. Again, the new concept is arises, that is, what are localized chemical bonds? We can see this is the figure, that is the sigma bond, a localized chemical bond. This is the diagram of the sigma bond. Okay, this is the localized chemical bond, or normal sigma and pi bond, or lone electron pair that exists on a single atom. These bonds are concentrated on a limited region of a molecule. This region have a concentrated electron distributed. In other hand, the electron density of this region is very high. We can see here this is a bond and this circle is electron density is present around the bond. A localized bond form when 2 molecular orbital of the 2 state atom overlap with each other. Sigma bonds may form due to overlap of 2 s orbital, 2 p orbital, or s p overlap. What are localized and delocalized types of bonding? We can see step by step. Chemical bonds are formed when 2 nuclei share a pair of electrons between them. For example, hydrogen molecule is there. Hydrogen molecule is H2 formula. In hydrogen, 1 sigma bond is present. When 1 electron share with another 1 electron, then form 2 electron, or we call formation of the sigma bond, or we can also call covalent bond. These spots are considered combination of overlapping one electron atom orbitals. The bond is strongest when the two electrons are confined to a region between the two nuclei. This type of bond is described as a localized bond. Delocalized bonding electrons are electron in a molecule, ion, or solid metal that are not associated with a single atom or covalent bond. For example, in benzene molecule, the delocalization of electron is indicated by circle. A molecule with delocalized bonding is more stable than molecule with localized bonding. What are delocalized chemical bonds? We can see the delocalized bond in benzene. Delocalized chemical bonds are the chemical bond that do not associate with only a single atom, but with several atom or other chemical bonds. We call the electron in this bond as delocalized electron. Delocalization occurs in the conjugated pi system. A conjugated pi system has double bond and single bond in an alternating pattern. We can see this is the delocalization of the electron in the benzene ring. There are 6 proton present, 3 pi bond present, means 6 electron present, and these electrons are continuously movement is occur. Alternately, double bond, single bond is present, and continuously these electrons are move around the ring. Then we call delocalization of the electrons. For example, the benzene ring has 3 single bond and 3 double bond in an alternating pattern. Each atom in this ring has a p orbital that does not undergo frontal overlapping. Therefore, this p orbital can have side overlapping. These kinds of overlap in the delocalization. We can indicate this is as 2 circles on the top of the benzene ring and the bottom of the ring. For example, in the middle is the benzene ring, and on the above side electron is movement, and below side is also electron is movement like that. We can indicate this is as 2 circles on the top of the benzene ring and the bottom of the benzene ring. These electrons are free to move throughout the molecule because they do not have a permanent binding to a single atom or covalent bond. Now we can see what is the difference between delocalized and localized chemical bonds. Localized chemical bonds are normal sigma and pi bonds or lone electron pair that exist on a single atom. The bond formed due to the frontal overlapping between orbitals, p orbital or s orbital. Moreover, these electrons are limited to a particular region between two separate atoms. Delocalized chemical bonds are the chemical bonds that do not associate it with only a single atom, but with several atoms or other chemical bonds. The bonds have electrons pair throughout the molecules that are free to move. These bonds form due to side overlapping of the p orbital. This is the main difference between delocalized and localized chemical bond. Summary: localized versus delocalized chemical bond. A chemical bond is a connection between two atoms. There are two forms of the chemical bond, are localized and delocalized chemical bonds. The difference between localized and delocalized bond is that localized chemical bond is a specific bond or lone pair electrons on a specific atom, whereas a delocalized chemical bond is a specific bond that is not associated with an single atom or covalent bond. The next concept is inductive effect, electromagnetic effect, resonance effect, and hyperconjugation. Actually, this is a very basic concept in the organic chemistry. All students must know that these are basic concepts, and these concepts you must understand. If you know these concepts, then you can easily understand the chemistry, reactions, different types of rearrangement, oxidation, reductions, reaction like that. Electronic factors that influence organic reaction include the inductive effect, electromagnetic effect, resonance effect, and hyperconjugation. These electronic factors involve organic molecules, most of which are made from a combination of the following six elements: carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur. Now we can see the first concept is a resonance. What is mean by a resonance? In this diagram, we can see this is the ozone molecule. In this ozone molecule, there are three different structures. Structure first, we can see here three oxygen atoms. On the middle oxygen atom, there are three bond attached to the oxygen. That's why valency is more. That's why positive charge are coming on the oxygen. Terminal one oxygen is satisfied to valency. Remaining one oxygen is only one bond attached. That's why negative charge are present on this oxygen. In this next structure, that is second structure, the electron movement or pi bond shifted to the another oxygen atom, and here negative charge appear on the left side oxygen. Now we can see the third structure. Both oxygen atom have only single bond, and middle oxygen is two bond is there. Now we can see when drawing the Lewis structure, the choice of the placement of the double bond is arbitrary, and either the choice is equal correct. The multiple correct ways of the drawing the Lewis structures are called the resonance form. Based on the resonance form, beginning chemistry students might wonder of the ozone has bond of the two different length. Since single bonds are generally longer than double bond, however, the ozone molecule is perfectly symmetrical with bond and that are the same length. The resonance hybrid is more stable than its canonical form. That is, the actual compound hybrid is at a lower energy state than its canonical form. Resonance stability increases with increased number of the resonance structure. This is the resonance structure of the benzene. We can see here double bond, single bond, double bond. And here on the other structure is exactly vice versa. Here double bond present, in the structure single bond. This is the resonance structure, or change the position of pi bond, or we can draw this structure, that is benzene ring, hexagonal structure, and the circle is denoted. That means the electrons are continuously moving. We can draw the structure like this, circle plus hexagon, that is benzene ring. The next concept is hyperconjugation. We can see what is the hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation helps explain the stability of the alkyl radical. It involves the delocalization of the sigma electron belong to the CH bond of the alkyl group attaching to an atom with an unshared pp orbital. The more the hyperconjugation hydrogen, the more is the stability. This is structure, that is Pauli's exchange repulsion. Here two lobes, that is the bonding orbital eclipse form. This is the antibonding orbital weaken the hyperconjugations. This third structure is the staggered. Both lobes are on the same side, that is strengthen hyperconjugation attractive. Because both lobes are on the same side, that's why the standard or the strengthen hyperconjugation, that is the attractive. This is the hyperconjugation concept. Thank you. Thank you very much.